All right. Here goes nothing.
Okay, Aaron, we're gonna do this by the book. You are currently inside the main airlock on deck 2. There are 4 decks in total, including the bridge.
And that's where the flight data can be accessed.
Which should tell us where the ship came from and, well, more importantly, the name of the ship it belongs to. Now, your main priority right now is to restore power back to the ship. Not gonna be able to do much without it.
It seems everything on this deck is powered down, including the 2 elevators. I need to find a way to bring them back online.
Well, airlocks in general usually have a backup generator. I'm not sure if it's the same in this case, considering the ship's unique design. Try and see if you can detect some kind of control panel.
I'll take a look around. John, the elevators are back in service.
Awesome. That takes care of that problem. Well, it's your pick where you want to go to first, but you still need to bring the main generator back online. It should restore power to most of the ship's components.
I can go either to deck 1 or deck 3.
Considering the main generator is down on deck 3, I suggest you go there first.
Gotcha. Deck 3. I guess this is the engineering deck?
That's right.
I found the generator. That does it!
Hold on, Aaron. There's another one.
Another generator?
Correct. It seems the ship runs on a dual-powered singularity system.
A what now?
It basically means the ship uses 2 generators to handle the power output throughout all the decks.
So, there's another generator I need to restore?
That's right.
I'll go search for it then.
Take a look around. Sometimes the power lines in these older ships are exposed. Use your object scanner to locate them. They should light up and show you which way to go.
Good idea. Thanks, John.
Always a pleasure.
I found the second generator. Did it work?
That did it, Aaron. I can see the major systems coming back online. You should be able to explore the rest of the ship now. Aaron, don't move. Stay right where you are.
What?
Stay right where you are. I'm detecting movement.
That can't be. There's no one here.
Hold on. Just one second. Oh my god. I'm so sorry, Aaron. It's a false alarm, just a maintenance droid. It seems like it was connected to the same power grid and got activated as well. It shouldn't pose a threat.
My god, Joe. My heart skipped a bunch of beats just now.
I should have expected this. I wasn't paying attention. I'm sorry, I wasn't thorough enough.
It's all right. Shows you're just human. We all make mistakes.
No, I can't accept that. I mean, if anything were to happen to you...
John, enough. I'm okay. Nothing happened. We're gonna move on from this, okay?
Copy that, Aaron. Let's keep going.
That's the spirit. We still have a whole ship to explore.
Okay, Aaron. Now that both generators are back online, I'm attempting some more scans. Alright, give me some time, let me assess the situation, and I'll come up with a game plan. I'll contact you ASAP. For now, you can make your way up to Deck 1.
On my way.
Oh, and Aaron, keep an eye out for any data pads lying around. They might contain information we can use.
You're acting like this is my first time doing this.
Well, excuse me, princess.
I can't believe I got that reference.
Yeah, I can't believe you got that either. So I tried getting into the ship's network, but it seems the mainframe is offline for the most part. I can't really do anything. You need to bring it back online.
Do you know where it's located?
Sorry, you're on your own. I'm being blocked off left, right, and center. I'm not able to access anything right now.
Don't worry, I'll find it. Something is completely off with this ship. There are no signs of any distress at all. There's no visible damage. Everything is just neat and tidy. It's almost like the entire crew just vanished.
I know. I've been going through all the data I collected so far, and from what I can tell, there's no fuel left. It's like it went as far as it could, then simply powered down. No distress signal or anything. It just doesn't make sense.
I don't like this one bit. Oh, wow. What happened here? John, are you seeing this?
Yeah, I'm seeing the creepy flower robot.
It seems like it ran out of power while attending the flowers. It's almost sad.
Red flags, Aaron. It clearly went beyond its protocols, and that usually isn't a good sign. Please be careful.
Don't worry. Whatever happened, it's displaying care rather than threat. And besides, it's powered down. John, come in. I'm inside the mainframe.
Copy that, Aaron. Boot her up. inside the network.
Yeah, I got a slight issue here.
What's that?
I'm trapped inside the mainframe. The doors closed when the servers came back online, and it's also locked up the door panel. I can't get out.
Yeah, that's a problem. Hold on. I should be able to open the doors from here. Okay, I've got some good news and some bad news.
Why doesn't that surprise me?
The good news is that I'm able to navigate the ship's network. The bad news is that the mainframe is directly linked to the security system. It looks like when I override the door controls, a lockdown protocol will be initiated to isolate any intruders inside the mainframe, and there's no way I can get around it. I can open the doors, but you'll have to manually disengage the alarm system.
Wow. Okay, that's, inconvenient.
Well, it's a non-lethal security system.
So all I gotta do is head for the security station and shut it off?
Yes, but after that, the security system will remain active.
What does that mean?
So let's say you're in the line of sight of a security camera. When that happens, you'll have 3 seconds before it triggers the alarm.
So I have to move out of their sight?
Correct, or else we'll trigger the alarm, lock down the entire deck, and you'll have to head back to the security station and reset the alarm.
Okay. Sounds easy enough.
It really is. Alright, I'm going to open the doors in 3, 2, 1.
Here I go. Man, I do not like security systems. They are way too noisy.
I know. Hey, Aaron, I have a new objective for you.
Lay it on me.
You need to shut down the security system manually. It's the only way to open up all the gates and give you access to the entire ship. There's a control room on Deck 1, which should let you shut it down from there. But first you need to figure out how to get to it. There's a gate blocking the way near Flower Robot.
Flower Robot? Really?
Oh, I'm sorry. I meant to say Creepy Flower Robot. Well, there's an elevator you can use to get there, though. You can access it through the cargo bay.
Okay, sounds good. Any ideas how to get to the cargo bay?
Well, you gotta head back to Deck 3 and find a way to unlock the elevator there. We'll sort the rest out when you reach it.
Sounds like a plan.
Before I forget, now that the mainframe is back online, you should be able to access the computer terminals on board. You can read emails, listen to audio logs, who knows what you'll find.
Good idea. Thanks.
And if you find anything by a Martian prince, do not believe it.
Roger that.
Thank you. Come in.
What's up?
I just found out the androids on the ship are also linked to the security system. There's one down there with you, remember?
What? Ah, fiddlesticks.
Fiddlesticks?
You're right. I almost forgot that.
It will trigger the alarm immediately if it sees you. And if you make enough noise, it'll be attracted to that. Just use your object scanner to avoid it.
Ah, great. As if I didn't have enough reasons to be creeped out by this thing.
Don't worry, I checked their security protocols, and they're also harmless. It won't attack you or anything.
Somehow that doesn't make it any less creepy.
Anywho, just locate the override control panel. That's the only way you're going to be able to open the doors to the control room.
Gotcha. The elevator doors are open.
Great. They should lead to the cargo bay.
Copy that.
Okay, Aaron. So, you basically just need to head over to the other side of the cargo bay to get to the elevator leading back to Deck 1.
Easy peasy.
About that. You're not gonna like this, but there are more androids down there, and a bunch of security cameras.
You're right. I don't like this.
It's not all bad, actually. I'm detecting a couple of network terminals down there. You should be able to use them to overload the, network. Just use whichever terminal you can and overload it. One of the androids will have to go down there and fix it, ignoring you along the way until it gets there and fixes the overload.
So I can distract them using that?
Correct. A cooldown timer will be shown on the display panel indicating how much time the android will need to fix the issue. It will start counting down once it arrives.
Okay, that's pretty helpful.
Indeed. So the time it takes for it to reach the terminal, plus the actual cooldown time, should give you a nice window to sneak through the rest of the cargo bay.
Okay, gotcha.
Just keep in mind that this does not affect the security cameras.
Okay. Oh, great. There's a gate blocking the path to the elevator.
There has to be a control panel somewhere down there.
Oh, I'm looking. Well, I'm finally at the security office.
There should be an override control panel somewhere inside. Official. Ship is all yours now. Wonder if it changed its name. Please don't call it the Enterprise. Alright, the security cameras as well as that android should leave you alone from here on out. All the security gates are opened and I'm able to navigate the network without any issues. For now, however, you're free to explore the entire ship. When you're done, you can head to the bridge and help me extract those coordinates.
Sounds good to me. Thanks, John. What would I do without you?
For a ship that's supposed to be 50 years old, it sure doesn't look like it.
Yeah, I agree. Technology-wise, everything is still above average compared to most ships today.
login rejected. Login rejected.
The bridge door is still closed.
Huh. I can't open it from here. It's set to manual override. You'll have to figure it out on your own. Sorry.
Okay, I'll get on it.
Login rejected.
John, I'm reading a log from the ship's captain. Her name is Selena Archer, and it's the Stardrop. The SD-01 belongs to the Stardrop.
I don't know how you keep doing it. I did have my suspicions earlier. Can't believe you actually guessed it.
It was the ship's initials that tipped me off. The SD-01 is actually the Stardrop 01. The log mentions the SD-00. That must be the Stardrop's real designation.
You're too good.
You better believe it.
John, come in. I'm on the bridge.
Great. The flight data should be on one of these terminals.
I'll take a look around. John, it's here. It's all here. This ship definitely belongs to the Stardrop. I still can't believe we found its location.
The Stardrop? Man, that's unreal. Holy cow. This calls for a celebration. Once you get back to the ship, I'm gonna party like it's 1999.
John, the bridge door closed.
I know.
John?
I know.
Can you hear me?
That voice.
Please respond, I don't have much time.
That voice.
I know.
What's going on?
Can you hear me?
I don't know, I...
John, trace the signal.
What?
Trace the signal, now!
Please respond, I don't have much time.
This is Aaron Vance. I can hear you. Who is this?
My name is Edo Hamada.
That's impossible.
I'm sorry. Why is that impossible?
Because Edo Hamada passed away over 90 years ago. You can't be him.
I don't know what. I need your help, please. I can't explain right now. I don't have the time. I'm sorry. All I ask is for you to help me. From one explorer to another. I'm sending the coordinates of my location. You're my only hope, Aaron Vance.
John, this can't be real.
I cannot explain what just happened. I traced the signal and it matches the coordinates I received. I also recorded the broadcast and downloaded whatever I could from the database. I'm gonna head back and analyze the data back home now, okay?
Okay. Home. I want to go home for now.
Just head back to the airlock. We leave the moment you're back on board. Are you okay? I know what you're thinking. How in God's name is Edo Hamada hailing us from the Stardrop? Just head back to the ship. I'm ready to leave when you are.